else have come to share with us. Pastors, thank you so much for your presence. To our missionary supervisor. And to all of you, my brothers and my sisters in Christ, it is good to be here. To help in celebrating 196 years of history. That's awesome. Awesome. Because 196 years ago, it is 86 African Americans who have been settled in Liberia by the American Colonization Society. 196 years ago, from New York to Sierra Leone, the immigration of African Americans began. 196 years ago, Spain was selling part of Florida to the U.S. 196 years ago, tomato was discovered to be non-poisonous. We've come a long way. I mean, to come from a time when African Americans were being resettled in Africa to when an African American president is leaving the White House, we've come a long way. So to be here today to celebrate, it's a wonderful day. Yeah. It's a marvelous day. Yeah. And I'm extremely delighted to be here to be a part of it. Thank you, Pastor, for the invitation. And it's just good to be here. Amen.
Yeah.
Are you glad to be here?
Challenging times.
through it all,
yes,
we are here to celebrate.
Yes.
As we look at the climate of human relationship today, as we look at what's going on even in the world today, it is so easy to give up, quit, and retire. But I come to have to say to you, don't give up. Just follow the instructions God has given to you. The purpose of this message is to show us today that things will come at you. As you are a living, breathing human being, things will come at you. I don't know whether you saw one of those commercials on the television that says, life comes at you very fast. Have you seen that? Wish I had the time to tell you what happened with that, but I won't do that. Things will come at you. But I want you to know that whatever comes against you, as an individual or as a congregation, to aggravate you, cause you to lose your focus. Don't give up. Just follow the instructions. Whatever others do to break up the spirit, and make you believe that you are a loser, don't give up. Just follow the instructions. They will come at you to create doubt in your mind.
Yes.
And make you feel that you are nobody. Don't give up. Just follow the instructions. They will come at you to destroy your dreams and leave you in a state of depression. Don't give up. Just follow the instructions. If you're not careful, things will come at you that will cause you to lose your enthusiasm. You can see it at church today. I'm not sure why some people go to church. Why go to church if they have to wear the worship? And the reason is that they've lost their enthusiasm. Some of us said that we can make it without God. I said things will come at you because you want to lose that enthusiasm for praise and for worship. But don't give up. Just follow the instructions. Life will cause you sometimes to want to actually give up and commit suicide.
My Lord.
Don't give up. Just follow the instructions. The key to this message, I want you to get this, is that if you are willing to believe that you are here in the universe for divine purpose, that's where we get all tripped up. When we fail to understand that we are here for a reason. You are here for a purpose. You may not have come to the realization, but don't worry about it. God has been allowing you to be here just to be here. You should have been dead. But God kept you. So you're here for a reason. And if you can believe that you are here for a purpose and a temple and come to that temple, don't give up. If you're open to receiving positive instructions to guide you, we are in an age today where folks don't want to follow instructions. Amen. You know, you didn't hear it. I won't repeat it. But Sister Gary came over and gave a little instruction to preside up again. And he just said, yes, ma'am. That's how we're going to take peace in the marriage. Can I tell somebody about you? Marriage Sometimes you need to be careful because your blessings become Saint Cyril is in the news today. One of his servants said to him, Master, if the prophet had said something so amazing, would you not have done that? Why don't you just follow the instructions that was given to you? And somehow God knew, and he listened, and went to the Jordan River.
Yes.
I can imagine men getting to the edge of the river, putting the big toe in the water, still not giving too good about it. Anyhow, he will do what was said to him. Father God, in the water. He went down the first time. He came back up, looked at his hands, still had leprosy. Went back the second time. Came back up, still had leprosy. Look at the skin. Look at the skin. is in it,
yes,
you can rest assured,
yes,
it's going to be all right.
Yes.
Joseph had a vision.
Well,
yes. It looked impossible.
Yes.
But he didn't quit.
Yes.
He went to prison.
Yes.
But God took him out.
Yes.
And made him vice president.
Yeah.
praise God.
Hallelujah.
I can tell many of you sitting here right now. Your problem is not the system.
Came to prayer meeting.
Only one person showed up. Came to Sunday school. Wonder if there's a fee. How you gonna back up this? Because what good is preaching the word when folk are not listening? And so God told me, please come and tell me. Don't give up now. Just follow the instruction. Jesus said, go ye into all the world. Preach, teach, baptize. The best investment you can make is not in the house. It's not in the stock market. The best investment you can make is in another life. I've been in many of the hospitals, and I've yet to see a dollar bill going down the hall to visit the city.